Hi folks, Lou here to talk about making changes in games after they're published. Specifically, I was asked, how do I feel about players changing the rules of my published games? Well, the obvious answer is, no game can be perfect for everyone. And the players should be able to figure out what they like. It's their game, I'm done with it, at least until there's a new edition, and so they can change it however they want. It's their part of their privilege. I learned game design by making variants, first of diplomacy, a little bit of risk, and then lots of extensions to D&D. It's easier to do that than to make games from scratch. And perhaps it's easier to get people to play those than to make a game from scratch and persuade people to play, especially nowadays when there's so many new games out. Now, the other thing I want to say here is that some games encourage variance, and I'd say that's a sign of a good game. For example, there are hundreds of diplomacy variants. There are lots of Britannia-like games that have been published separately that weren't my designs. And that started with Maharaja in, I think, I don't know when it was, sometime after Britannia was published, but I didn't see it until Avalon Hill was long dead because I was not participating in a hobby at that point. But we have Hispania, Italia. Many of these Britannia-like games tend to be more complex than Britannia itself. Whereas in my new designs, I'm going to simpler and shorter. And it's an interesting contrast. Of course, most of those more complex games were published quite a while ago. I've recently encountered another one called Invasions of Europe or something like that, by Philippe Thibault, a Frenchman, and it also is a much more complex game. It's all of Europe and North Africa, and there are over 500 pieces, and there's something like 150 areas as contrasted with 37 land areas in Britannia. But that's what some people like. Now, the likelihood of getting such games published in physical form becomes less and less as time goes on, because as the audience broadens for hobby games to where we're really playing party games like Cards Against Humanity and Werewolf, as that audience broadens, they tend to like shorter and shorter games. And a more complex version of Britannia, a game that lasts 4 to 5 hours as it is likely to be quite long. Now, I think some of those will be published as computer games, because the contrast in computer games is that computer games tend to be much more complex. I'm thinking of Europa Universalis and Hearts of Iron and things like that, which often are really resource management games and not war games. In other words, you manage your resources well enough, you're going to win the war anyway because you're going to have so much more and so much better stuff than anybody else. But a lot of people like that kind of game, and so those people might like the really long Britannia-like games. I mean, I have really long Britannia-like games myself, but I haven't tried to get any published. So, overall, if people want to change my game, that's fine. If they want to change it so much that they issue it as a standalone game, that's fine. That's a compliment to me and to Britannia. I don't know why you'd have a different attitude. Thanks for listening.